COVID-19 being a new virus, there's a lot we don't know about it. For example, is it possible for the virus to compromise our drinking water? Chris Crocket is with the organization called Aqua, Ohio. He is the chief safety officer, and he joins us now with some insight. Chris, first of all, thank you very much for giving us some time this morning. Let's talk about your agency first and foremost. What do you do as it relates to drinking water?
Aqua, Ohio serves water and wastewater for over 500,000 customers in 19 counties throughout Ohio. And we also serve drinking water for customers over 8 different states in the Aqua America territories.
Let's talk about this thing. Everybody's concerned about the, you know, COVID-19 situation, and you know, you can't touch anything. It lives for so long on different surfaces. But what about drinking water? Can this thing survive in drinking water?
No, COVID-19 cannot survive in drinking water, but it's a good question. It's something we've been dealing with for 100 years. Our whole goal in drinking water is to remove and inactivate and disinfect viruses and bacteria ever since the days of typhoid. And so this is something we've been well-storied and well-practiced in, is killing viruses.
Talk about how you test the water, especially when we're dealing with a situation like we are right now.
Okay, so drinking water is tested from every step, from where we take it from a river or stream or lake, the whole way through the water treatment process, which includes multiple barriers and steps, and then on its way out to the customer and ultimately at the tap in locations throughout the drinking water system where it's delivered to the customer. And we test for a number of things. Sometimes we're running equipment that's testing the water every minute for how it looks, clarity. But we are, two of the main indicators that we test for are chlorine and bacteria. And if we detect chlorine, that's good. And if we detect bacteria, that's bad. So as long as we make sure we're detecting the chlorine and we're not detecting the bacteria, your water is safe.
As new viruses come about, do you have to develop new testing mechanisms, new testing procedures?
Typically what happens is they do studies where they look at viruses as families or pathogens as families, and then they do studies in laboratories as to how they're removed, and then they tell us what the performance, how to treat and remove it, and set the parameters on what we have to do to make sure we're always removing that. And then we use these indicator tests for bacteria and other things to make sure that it's working properly. So we don't have to test for every specific virus under the sun, or we'd be testing for thousands of things.
So in closing, what's your message to Northeast Ohioans, people who are concerned about their water supply?
Your drinking water is absolutely safe. Do not go out to buy bottled water and expose yourself to the virus. You're taking a greater chance doing that than getting the absolute safe drinking water that's in your home. And make sure that you, if you are coming back to a building that's reopening that hasn't been opened in months or weeks, flush the water out for 10 minutes from the cold taps and from the hot taps to make sure that it's got that chlorine in there.
Aqua, Ohio's Chief Safety Officer Chris Crocket, thank you very much. Good information this morning. Appreciate you, man. Thank you.
Thank you, Wayne.
All right, you as well.